installation. My name is Arno Lambert. I'm working for the IOC project office for IOD in Ostend in Belgium, together with Peter P. Siersens. I have a short presentation about the ODIS catalog of sources. The first thing I want to show is what the ODIS catalog of sources is not. It's not the same as ODIS, yes, because we have ODIS, SODIS, OBIS, all those acronyms, but that is not the case. So the ODIS catalog is not that. It's not a data portal neither. As you see, we don't have data sets as so. We just are a catalog of sources, so we contain the sources. It's not an ocean database of or metadata repository neither. It's not a real finished product of a final product, because it's a work in progress. While people are adding sources to ODIS CAT, they point us to things that are missing or things that are difficult, so it's still evolving for the future. And it's very important that it's not limited to the IOC or IOD communities. What you can expect is that it's an online browsable and searchable catalog of existing high quality, ocean-related and web-based data sources and services. We try to visualize the landscape by providing information on products. And so we want to have the entities and their connections with all the ocean data and information sources. We want to guide people to show where we can find data and products and services and that contain all those very important data. It's also very, very pointed to policymakers and non-UN intergovernmental organizations and global regional organizations. So it's special for the people like we are here together now, is for all you. And very important is that's like one of the pillars that where ODIS and Ocean Info Hub will be built on upon. Very important here is that we have 16 different categories. The ones that are highlighted here are the ones that are taken for Ocean Info Hub as being the ones that we will build pilots upon. But that will be explained by Lucy Scott later on. And the categories are peoples, documentations, vessels, maps, and training opportunities. Later on, with Lucy will explain that. It's very easy to enter things over there. So please go over there to that URL. You can log in with your Ocean Expert credentials. If you don't have Ocean Expert credentials yet, please ask them. It's easy to subscribe over there. Just add your information. You have basic descriptions. We mainly have like a URL where we can find the source. It should be a valid URL, of course, and that will be checked online to see if that is working or not. We need a name, and we need contact information. And then we also need those advanced descriptions, which is more about the content of the source itself, where we ask a data policy to see if it's open, if there are restrictions on the source. What type of source you're showing is one of the 16 types I showed before. And very important is that we want to know how machines can interact with that source. So that's something we need later on for the Ocean Info Hub. So that's important also. You know that everybody has things to do, so we don't have enough time to fill in another registry and another data sourcing. So if you think you have too many sources and it's too difficult to fill them all, we can provide you an Excel file. You can fill that Excel file with a row for every source that you have. You send that file back to us, we import that, and afterwards we can see what can be done with the source itself. At the very moment, Christian Munoz, who is also joining this workshop, is busy with the quality control for the more than 1,000 resources we already have for the moment. He's about halfway for the moment. And what you see here at the left side bottom is what has been found and was missing before he has quality controlled the sources. And at the right side, you can see what has been done by Christian for the moment. Which is important here is that there's like one bar missing, but it's not really missing that people are not really keen to fill in not mandatory fields. So that's something that might be worked upon. Christian found that these are the main problems in the data for the moment. They are missing or incomplete abstracts. Keywords are a bit messy for the moment. A lot of interaction technologies are not mentioned or not correct. Metadata standards, same thing. And the data flow also from where is the data coming, where is it going to? So these things are also not very well done for the moment. And the last thing is like the categories. Christian found out that for the moment we have a lot of data source, which is like a logic, but we are missing like software. We are missing these ones. And that should be better in the future after that. Okay, thank you very much.